I hope you enjoy this talk. I'll talk for about 45 minutes to 1 hour. You can, if you wish, stop me and ask me questions. Or you can keep your questions and ask me at the end. I won't be in a hurry to go away. I'll answer your questions. Okay. You know, in India, in some rural areas, there used to be, I think there still is a practice, where once a week, everybody gathers round and there is a sale, like a fair, where people bring their goods to sell, etc. Okay? The goods would include live animals also. So there was a fair and a person had come with a cow to sell the cow amongst others. Others were there also selling cows. This person's cow was, what shall I say, very handsome, very tall, very strong, good looking, okay, and fleshy. And there are other cows which are not really so good. Some of them are even lean and scraggy, looking half-fed, undernourished, etc. There was an observer who was observing this and he found that people used to come, talk, discuss about that cow, but nobody really bought that cow. The fair got over like this at the evening at about 5 o'clock and that cow was still not sold. The cow was still not sold, whereas all the other cows were sold for whatever price. So this made this man very curious to know why so when this cow is so outstandingly good as compared to the other cow, and why is it not fetching a price, or why is it not getting a buyer? So he went and asked the person, why do you think, how do you explain this fact? Then this man opened up and said, no, I agree with you, my cow has got all the good qualities. It is tall, it is strong, it is good looking, it is fleshy, lot of flesh on it. But the cow has got only one defect. And that is putting the buyers off. And what is that defect? Then he was asked. And the person, the owner said, the only defect the cow has got is that it does not give any milk. Okay. So a person without good communication skills, without good speaking skills, is like that cow which has got all good qualities but does not give milk. You will not be able to market yourself so well if you don't communicate well. That is the lesson of the story. So we need to communicate, and we are now living in a world in which communication is becoming increasingly more important. And public speaking is one of the effective ways of communicating. Public speaking is one of the effective ways of communicating. So let's ask, what is public speaking then? Today's topic is public speaking. What is public speaking according to you? Anybody?
Any topic.
Yeah, but what is it, public speaking? Speaking in front of? Yeah, in front of a group of people. Okay, fine. Is it important, public speaking skills? Yes, public speaking skills. One thing is, public speaking is a very exhilarating and exciting adventure. It's a great experience to speak in front of people. It gives you a tremendous feeling of strength and power, you know, to hold people's attention, to talk to people and stuff. And I look at public speaking as you said, talking in front of audience. It is nothing but expanded private conversation. Or you can call it amplified private conversation. I talk to you, two persons, and I talk to 20 persons. I'm the same person, the content is same. Then why does public speaking still become so difficult? That's the next question. Before that, let's define public speaking. Public speaking can be defined simply as the art and science of establishing an effective oral communication with an audience. The art and science of establishing an effective oral communication with an audience. Okay. And what's an audience? Audience is any group of people. Two or more persons, targeted group is an audience. One thing you have to remember, but people who are in close relationship with you, who are in special relationship with you, they do not constitute an audience. So talking with your family, your friends, that is not public speaking. Okay, so public speaking is the art and science of establishing an effective oral communication with an audience. Okay, so by its very definition, you'll know that there are only three main ingredients of public speaking. One is the speaker, the other is the audience, and third is the speech. We'll elaborate on these three aspects of public speaking. The speaker, the speech, and the audience. Okay. So what should the speaker be, first and foremost? Can you tell me? What type of speaker would you like to have before you? Or which, who would you like as your speaker? What qualities would you like to see? Should know thoroughly about the subject. Then? Enthusiastic.
Simple language.
What else? Confidence. Convincing. Cheerful. Like me. Okay, thank you. What else? Okay, so you know the answer. So let's sum it up. Essentially, the speaker should be lively and energetic. Now, listening is a very difficult skill. And if the speaker himself is dull, you know what can happen to the audience. The speaker should be lively and energetic. Secondly, the speaker should be enthusiastic. What should he be enthusiastic about? He should be enthusiastic about himself. He should be enthusiastic about the audience. He should be enthusiastic about the speech, the topic. Not only he should know it well, but he should be enthusiastic about the topic. He should love the topic. And he should be enthusiastic about the occasion. I'm speaking at the health library. I'm speaking to a group of people dedicated to self-development. Okay. So he should be enthusiastic, lively. Then the other things follow. He should be friendly. He should have cheerfulness on his face. He should be poised. Something might go wrong. He should not get upset. The electricity might fail. The mic may not work. You know, and a good speaker is one who will take that in his stride. Poised. He should be poised. And he should be natural. Everybody is a unique personality. He should not lose his uniqueness. He should speak naturally. Yeah, he can try and pick up good qualities of others, but he has to be himself. He should be natural. And as somebody rightly said, he should be able to elicit confidence. And most importantly, what I feel for a good speaker is, he should enjoy his talk. He should be happy. When he comes there, he should look happy. Not, my God, he's got something on his head and he's come. You know, he should be happy. Okay. The speaker should have these qualities. Okay. Then we come to what is known as the platform presence of the speaker. Now what will come under that? First will be the posture of the speaker. What should be the posture? Is the way you hold your body. When you sit, when you stand. We'll talk about standing only because most of the public speaking is done by standing. So what should be the posture of the person speaking?
Body should speak out.
Yeah, but what? Can we be more specific?
Comfortable.
Comfortable means what? Like that I should stand? I'm comfortable. Stand erect? Yeah. Stand erect like this? No. Yeah. So you must be professionally relaxed. Professionally relaxed.
Natural
erect, shoulders parallel to the ground. No stooping, no slouching, but not ramrod erect also like this. Not stiff. Very natural. Feet, look at my feet. Weight evenly distributed. Stand on both your feet. There are many speakers who don't stand on both their feet. They'll stand on one leg like this, then one leg like this. Okay. So stand on both your feet. Feet slightly apart. Not too much apart like this. And not like this, when we were small children like this. Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch. Okay. The feet slightly apart. Okay. Weight evenly distributed. Professionally relaxed. And in natural stand. This is simple posture of a good speaker. Okay. Few things to avoid. Don't speak with your hands in your pocket. See, this posture is bad. You can't even make any gestures. Okay. In a very long speech, if being a 1 hour, 2 hours, maybe for 2-3 minutes, one can even stand like that and talk. That may be okay. That may, if it's part of your personality, if you're an informal person, you can do that. But generally, avoid hands in your pocket. Avoid folding your hands this way. This is a very defensive posture. It will affect your voice also. It will affect your spontaneity also. I was conducting public speaking class and I taught one class and I ended the class that way, that don't stand with your hands in front, and that is a comment I made to one of the good speakers. Don't fold your hands in front of. And then when the next time that girl had to speak, she came and stood like this. Why, what happened? Sir, you told me not to put my hands in front, so I'm putting it behind. So this also is a bad posture. Behind or in this way or hands. And fourth is what is known as a fig leaf position. Fig. F-I-G, fig. You know what is a fig? It's a tree over there. Fig leaf. Leaf of the tree. It's called a fig leaf position. I'll tell you why it's called. Those of you are familiar with the Bible or Christian religion, and including Judaism and Islam, they all believe in the Adam and Eve theory. Adam and Eve were the first human being. They were living naturally in heaven. Okay, they were not aware of anything. Then God told them to enjoy everything that was in heaven, except not to eat from that particular fruit at particular